Hey everybody, it's Tom, and we're back again with another comic book haul. Today I'm going to show some books that I got at the New Jersey Comic Expo back on November 19th, and some books that I picked up at Zapp's 50% off sale, and another 50% off sale that I went to. But first, I was at the mall the other day with my wife and my daughter, and they were looking around the mall, and I stopped in the Disney store, and they had a whole shelf full of things that were on sale, and this guy here was $20 on sale from regularly $34.95, so $35 plus tax normally. And I got him for $20. You know, I missed out on the Black Series Vader. I wasn't able to find him. And this was the only one they had left in the store. So I picked him up. So I'm glad to grab that. First, I got some books here from a fellow YouTuber, Why Not Art. He went to the Midtown Comics warehouse sale. And you know, I asked him if he could look for a couple of books for me, and he was nice enough to grab a couple of things. Moon Knight number 34 and number 35 for my Moon Knight run. He knows I'm a Red Sonja fan, and he got me this, as well as this amazing Atlantis Rises cover. This was the book that I was most happy to get. I never knew this existed. He got it from the Joe Koch warehouse, actually. The Detectives. It's an Adam Hughes cover. And interiors as well. So thank you, Tony. I really appreciate it. And I've got a little something for you that I'm going to be sending to you shortly. Nothing as cool as that. So next, this pile of books here. This giant stack here. I was looking through some long boxes at the con right here, and a dealer had, you could fill up a long box for $80, or you could fill up one of those plastic comic bags that you get at your local shop for $30. So I took that challenge, and everything that you're going to see here, I got in the bag for $30. You know, to fit more books, I was taking some of the books out of their bag and board so I can try to squeeze as many books as I can into that plastic bag. So first we got Battle of the Planets number 1, Michael Turner cover. You know, anytime I see Marvel Bronze Age stuff, I pick it up, including Marvel 2-in-1 number 76, Promethea number 1. A J. Scott Campbell book that I'd never seen before, Wild Siders. Masters of the Universe, number 1, the J. Scott Campbell cover. Batman, number 34, from New 52. Detective Comics, 806. Detective's another title that if I see it on the cheap, I'll pick it up. You know, I collect the main title, Batman, or... Since Detective has been around longer, I guess that would be the main title, but I collect Batman and Detective on the side. Wonder Woman number 5. Batman Odyssey number 4, slowly getting this miniseries put together. Detective number 639, and what's cool about this book, it's one of the first appearances of Sonic the Hedgehog. So that was a pretty cool find. X-Force 19. This book actually was not part of that lot. I found this for a dollar. Web of Spider-Man number 18. It's like a cameo appearance of Venom. X-Men number 154. And then these were pretty cool. Call the Conqueror, number 7. So I grabbed anything that was Bronze Age, that was in decent shape. So we got number 7, and it jumps up to 18. feels thicker. Oh, it's because there's extra boards in here. Number 20. Number 23. 25. I don't know how many issues is in this run. I'll have to check. Found a pretty cool Iron Man number 161 with Moon Knight. Iron Man 212 with the border. Got a nice little run of Eternals as well in the bag. So we can get a little bit closer. Number 6. I haven't rebagged any of these yet. Number 7. 11. 17. And King Size Annual number 1. Found Marvel 2-in-1 number 75 with the Avengers. John Carter, Warlord of Mars, number 18. And number 24. This was cool. I wish I found more, but only one. Wonder Woman 223. This book was popular for a little bit. Teen Titans Spotlight number 14 on Nightwing. It's, if memory serves me, it's the first pairing of Batman and Nightwing. Marvel Premiere number 42. And then some Batman annuals. Number 12. Number 11. Number 9. Number 8. I think one or two of those were double. Green Lantern Zero. First appearance of... what's it? Connor Hawk, I think, is the character's name. Then I got a bunch of these Neil Adams variants that were in the boxes as well, and somebody was trying to get 10 bucks a piece for them at one point, but I got them for like 50 cents. Aquaman 49, Spider-Woman number 2, Rocket Raccoon variant, another issue of Promethea number 1, so if anybody needs that, hit me up, I'll trade with you. Captain America number 1. This is the Steranko variant. Sinestro number 20. Neil Adams. Martian Manhunter number 9. Teen Titans number 17. Titans Hunt number 5. So a lot of decent books. And you know, I found all of these at the end of the con instead of the beginning of the con. I could just imagine what were in those boxes. So I found these during like the last hour of the con after it was picked through the whole day, including this Punisher 102. It's a pretty expensive book when it's in high grade. And X-Men 267, it's like the second or third appearance of Gambit, depending on who you speak to. Daredevil 192, 241, found a couple copies of 270, first appearance of Blackheart, two copies of that, some Gen 13s that I did not have, so we got number 15, some more Michael Turner. These were cool. These are 1 in 50 sketch variants that I found in the box that I'd never seen these before. So I found 2 copies of this. And then I found the regular with 2 copies of that. Detective number 32 was the combo pack with the digital copy, but this was already opened out of its poly bag. And then some more Adams Hughes stuff. Superman Returns prequel number 4. Amazing Spider-Man 626. This Amazing Red Sonja number 8. Detective 807. This is a book I bought strictly for the cover. Something about the cover I liked. Revival number 6. Batman 689, Action Comics 894, another Michael Turner cover, Soulfire Zero, Batman Odyssey number 5, and number 6. I may be close to finishing this now. And Deviate number 1 with the J. Scott Campbell cover. So all those books cost me $30. So I was very happy to fill the bag up with those. I'm running out of room to put books, so I've got to get some more boxes. Just moving these to the side. All right. Whoops, books are going everywhere. Technical difficulties. All right. Sorry about that. No editing to be done. Also in this haul, you're going to see my first CBCS submission that I've ever gotten. I got that from Baltimore. It came in recently. So this was the program. And then they were giving this away. I grabbed a couple copies of that. Miracle Man number 12. Adam Hughes cover. I got this for $5. Liberty Meadows number 2. Actually, this was, $5. I got paid for that. These next couple books were $2 a piece. The Flintstones number 23. I was very surprised to find all these. Tomb Raider 43, all Adam Hughes covers. Number 41, number 3, number 4, and number 2. Those were all $2. Hanna-Barbera's Laugh Olympics. So I was glad to grab this for $2. I'm trying to grab all these cartoon books from like when I was a kid. Megilla Gorilla was 5. And then this was 10. I bought this from the Dynamite dealer. Dynamite booth, sorry. So this was signed by the artist and the writer, Amy Chu and Jim Ballant. I love this Kiss cover. It's got like a love gun feel to it for me. And then I found this for $1. Kiss number 1. These next books, he had a sale for, I think it was like 3 for 20. Something like that on his table. But I wound up paying less than cover on all these things here. So this reprints the Treasury Superman versus Spider-Man. This compilation was part of the deal. And then this. So I got all three of these books for $20. I mean, this cover's beat up really bad. But I'm still glad to have that. I like to get my hands on, excuse me, on Silver Age Batman and Joker covers. It's got some condition issues. Cover's still attached, though. Then I figured for like $8, why not? Next, the Hulk magazine, number 25. I thought I needed this. I didn't, so this is a double. And I paid $5 for it. No big deal. Next are the books that I got from Zap Comics. We got Batman number 192. This was only $5. Carmine Infantino cover. Punisher number 4. First appearance of Microchip. Paid 50 cents for that. Fantastic Four 59 was only $4. You know, anytime I can get a decent condition Silver Age book for, you know, under $10, I'm all over that. I would have paid $8 for this. This was a steal. Supergirl number 1, They had a $12 sticker price on it. I got it for $6, and it's in really high grade. Only problem is, if you could see right there, corners are sharp, no spine roll, no spine ticks, just that little ding across here. Invincible Iron Man number 10. I got that for $6. I'm trying to get the first 10 issues. I've got most of them. Avengers number 89 with Captain Marvel. I got that for $5. This was a book I was glad to find. It was on my want list. Avengers number 70. I wanted it because it was the first appearance of Nighthawk. So I got that for $6. And then the last book I picked up there was Thor 171. I'm a big Wrecker fan, and this was in pretty high grade, or decent grade. I wouldn't say high grade, because if I graded it, it'd probably come back as like a 7. That was $6. So the last group of books are some other books that I got from another 50% off sale. But they also had some quarter bins, and I was able to grab Lady Zorro number 4. So I like Michael Linsner. Joseph Michael Linsner. Barbed Wire, Adam Hughes cover for a quarter. And then some Michael Turner's Witchblades. These are pretty cool, and that's not nudity. She's got something on there. Queen of Vampires number 2. And number 1, some amazing painted covers on these. Another kiddie type book from my childhood. Hanna-Barbera TV Stars, Captain Caveman, Grape Ape. Looks like maybe Yogi Bear on there. Got that for $2.50. Dracula Lives, I got that for 75 cents. Cover price. And that was issue number 11 and number 12. This is a book that was on my top 10 list. Detective Comics number 475, and I forgot to grab my list. So I got 8 out of the 10 books I was looking for. The only books remaining from my list, which I probably will not get, Iron Man 55 and Marvel Premiere 15, I think it is, the first appearance of Iron Fist. But I wanted the Joker Fish issue for a while. And this book has been at the shop for about 2 years. And every time they have the sale and I go to buy the book, they keep telling me, well, no, it doesn't count Joker covers, which is the weirdest things I ever heard. But I was finally able to get it for 50% off. So I got it for $23, which was a price I was definitely comfortable paying for this book. And then the last couple of books, Vampirella number 15, I got for $3. And the big book that I got from the sale, it's a Michael Turner sketch variant signed by Michael Turner. 17 out of 499 copies. It's one of those Dynamic Forces books with a certificate. They wanted 50. I got it for 25. So I was very, very happy to get that. Last book is my first sketch cover and my first CBCS submission that I've ever done. I probably won't do too many more of these because it is a bit expensive and the weight is just murder. I couldn't wait to get this back. But here we go. Drum roll and pow. Wonder Woman 36, 9.8, signed and sketched by Adam Hughes. I'll get a little bit closer on that. See if I can eliminate some of the glare. So I was very happy to get this done. You know, I was looking at his table. He had prints that were for the same amount. And I figured I might as well just get myself an original sketch. So there we go. So this is probably the last haul that I'll have for this year. I may do another video showing the top my favorite books that I picked up this year. So thanks for watching. Thanks to all my new subscribers. And until next time, we'll see you guys soon. Take care.